Approximately 15,000 years ago, a wall of water more than 150 meters or 500 feet in height raced across a section of central Washington state. As this flood quickly overflowed the natural boundaries of river channels, it began depositing house-sized boulders on cliffs and creating giant ripples in the landscape. In the span of only a few hours, thousands of towering and large hills were created in the landscape as hundreds of feet thick of sediment were distributed over a vast area of the Ice Age-era grasslands. As this flood progressed along the Columbia River near the modern town of Arlington in Oregon, flood heights surpassed 1,150 feet. At its peak, this flood had a volume which was more than 10 times the combined output of every single river on the planet. What had just occurred was one of the Missoula floods, which had a dramatic impact in the landscapes of both Oregon and Washington. These occurred more than a dozen times, each time vastly changing the overall topography which the water flowed across. As an example, look at these several hundred foot tall layers of sediment. It may be hard to believe, but all of it was deposited in only the span of 2,000 years from these energetic floods. So, how did these floods occur? Where did all of the water originate from? What are the various features it created? This video will answer these three questions and discuss this repeating Ice Age era natural disaster. 15,000 years ago, the Ice Age was still ongoing as a thick glacial ice sheet stretched across all of Canada and covered the northern half of Washington state. Although it was much colder than it is today, the planet was slowly beginning to warm, causing ice sheets to retreat and thus generating a large amount of glacial runoff. Over the span of several decades, a large lake was built around the modern town of Missoula in Montana. This lake did not simply flow to the west towards the ocean, as its only natural outlet was blocked by a thick sheet of ice on the Fort Clark River in Idaho. Over time, the lake became increasingly deep, reaching depths of more than 1,500 feet and grew to contain more than 500 cubic miles of water. This unusually deep lake caused such a drastic pressure increase at the bottom of the lake and the adjacent ice dam that the freezing point of water was lowered far below normal. This allowed liquid water to seep into small cracks present in the ice dam. Over time, friction from water flowing through these cracks created heat which further expanded these to become fissures, thus allowing even more heat to be generated as additional water flowed through. This feedback loop continued until the ice could no longer support the pressure behind it, causing a catastrophic collapse. This glacial outburst flood caused the vast majority of Lake Missoula to drain away in only the span of 48 hours. As a wall of water raced across Idaho and into Washington, it overtopped the comparatively shallow river channels. The energy of this flood broke apart large segments of basaltic rock from the Columbia River flood basalts, causing house-sized boulders to be carried with the flood. As these floods overtopped cliffs, some of these boulders became permanently in place there. Continuing onwards, the flood entered an area of Washington now referred to as the Channel Scablands. It subsequently towered over a bend in the Columbia River, depositing an abundance of sediment and creating giant ripples in the landscape which are similar to those seen in a shallow sea today, except they were each 250 feet wide. Elsewhere, mounds of gravel the size of skyscrapers were deposited, leaving behind an abundance of these unique features. Due to the drop of 850 feet in elevation and only 3 miles, water quickly gouged away a several hundred foot deep channel while creating a several mile long Niagara Falls-like waterfall. Today, this feature is termed the potholes coulee. The floodwater eventually got backed up at a very narrow stretch of the Columbia River called the Wallula Gap, which led to the creation of a temporary 400 foot deep lake named Lake Lewis. Water then finally flowed into the ocean, depositing several cubic miles of material there. The sequence of events just described repeated another 39 times, with one such event occurring approximately every 50 years between 15,000 and 13,000 years ago. By the time all of these floods had occurred, some areas had been buried by more than 1,000 feet of fresh sediment. This process only stopped once the ice sheet had retreated far enough that it no longer dammed the body of Lake Missoula, causing it to freely flow towards the ocean. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.